हेलो ये अखिल श्रीवास्तव तो टीचिंग यू फिजिक्स ऑफ क्लास 10 चैप्टर 10 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी लाइट रिफ्लेक्शन एंड रिफ्रैक्शन। इन दिस द रिफ्रैक्शन यू हैव सीन इन द प्रीवियस, नाउ यू विल सी द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स। रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स वी हैव सीन दैट द साइन आई अपॉन साइन आर, साइन आई अपॉन साइन आर इज कॉल्ड द साइन आर इज कॉल्ड रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स कॉन्स्टेंट विच इज नोन एज बाय स्नेल्स लॉ इट इज ए रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑन मीडियम टू विद रिस्पेक्ट टू मीडियम वन। इफ देर इज अ टू मीडियम्स गिवन, देर इज अ टू मीडियम इज गिवन, वन इज द मीडियम वन एंड वन इज द मीडियम वन इज द मीडियम टू। वन लाइट रे कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस मीडियम एंड गोइंग टू दिस डायरेक्शन एट द नॉर्मल it bends towards that is direction. So here is the angle I and here is the R. Then we can see that the sin I refractive index of medium 2 with respect to 1 with respect to 1 will be sin I upon sin R. But we know that light travels from one medium to another medium also changes its speed. So, by the changing of speed, we can write the symbol of, we can use the mu r n. It is a mu r n. Simply n, refractive index of the medium 2 with respect to 2 1 is equal to speed of light in 1 upon speed of light in 2, speed of light in medium 2. So that we can say the V1 upon V2, or if the light is coming out from second medium to the first medium again. Here again, if it is air, it is a glass, and again it is air. So you can say the air with respect to glass. Here what we will say? Glass with respect to air. Here air with respect to glass. With respect to glass means N12 will be V2 by V1. You can say what you want that speed will be. In that out, if you want this, it is the speed of light. We know the speed of light in the air, in the vacuum. Vacuum is equal to, which is C called, generally we know the C, 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. It is the speed of light in the vacuum. So, if we take the vacuum as the place of air, then at the place of air, you can take the air vacuum, glass with respect to vacuum, or medium, anything you want to get medium to, with respect to vacuum. Then the n, any medium, n1 or n2, one is not needed, you will get speed of light in vacuum upon speed of light in the medium. Any medium, suppose the medium is 2 and 1 is act as the vacuum. Then refractive index in C by V, which is called the absolute refractive index. Absolute refractive index. It is called absolute refractive index when the any medium refractive index you want with respect to vacuum. Generally, vacuum speed is same. So according to the speed, the refractive index of the mediums are different. So C is a constant for all the mediums, because 3 into 10 power 8 is the speed of light in a medium. So you will get, it is an absolute refractive index of the medium directly, not with respect, directly you can get absolute refractive index of the medium, which like a glass or water or any other substance you can take, you can take that medium, you can write the absolute refractive index, means the first medium is vacuum. And then medium for any medium, so you can write N2 or you can write N refractive index N M medium is equal to C by V of medium, velocity in that medium. Any medium, it may be glass, it may be air, it may be water, or it may be any other. So this is the very important part of this refractive index you are seeing. Refractive index is the ratio of the velocities as well as the ratio of the sin I upon sin R, angle of incidence upon angle of refraction with sin, trigonometric ratios, one special name, sin 90, sin 30, sin 40, sin, like this we will take. Absolute refractive index, some materials refractive index are given in your book, table air refractive index is given 1.0003. So like this you are seeing the 1.2.42 is the diamond, refractive index is the diamond. So note here, you, what are you going to say, that the refractive index of the crown glass is given here, helpful means need not to memorize that, you will get in your examination what is the refractive index. Absolute refractive index of the medium is simply called the refractive index. If the refractive index is given, it means you must understood yourself, absolute is not needed. Only refractive index is given, it means it is absolute. It is calculated by the help of, so least here given in the air, it is 1.003. So in the denser medium, optically denser medium may not be possessed greater mass density. For example, kerosene you are seeing here, it is given kerosene 1.44. And the higher refractive index. For example, kerosene having the higher refractive index is optically denser. If the refractive index is more, it means it is a denser medium. If refractive index is less, then it means it is the rarer medium. So refractive index gives you the, so denser medium, optically denser medium than the water, because water is a less than mass of, mass density is less than the water. So that's why you are getting denser medium, optically denser medium than water, which is given in the kerosene. Kerosene is in the table 1.44. So ability of the medium of the refractive index, refract light is also expressed in the term of the optical density. Optical density, what is the optical density? Has a definite connotations, that is, it is not the same as mass density. We have been using the term rarer medium and denser medium. So actually means the optically rarer medium and optically denser medium. So a medium is optically denser and optically rarer depends on the number of particles, number of the atoms present there. That's all for today, and next we will meet to the spherical refraction through the spherical lenses. We will study the refraction through the spherical lens, that we know the concave lens and the convex lens. Thanks for today.